chicken, and that we still have, I still don't understand it all, inflation on top of inflation. So that made sense. Yes.
Rule number two. Every dollar that is borrowed from the Treasury is a promise to tax you until the day you die.
Wow.
Those are the two rules of a debt-based currency system. So if you reverse engineer those two rules, you know how the two sure ways to guarantee yourself a rate of return. There is no such thing as a guaranteed investment. Even investments that say they're guaranteed because the government says they're guaranteed are not guaranteed. Guaranteed investments is a figment of your imagination. But there are two rules to guarantee yourself a rate of return based on the two rules of a debt-based currency system. Number one is to reduce your cost of borrowing. And number two is to make all your payments as tax-efficient as possible. So a lot of times we spend our time out there looking at our finances, and we say after we've earned $50,000 a year or whatever it is, and we're like, you know what? I'm going to take that little sliver of savings that I have, and I'm going to go put it into some sort of an investment out there, and hopefully that little small percentage is going to grow so that I can have my retirement. Yet at the same time, we're spending 50% of our money on taxes, and we're spending another 34% of our money on interest. And so wouldn't it make more sense if we tacked the taxes and the interest versus that little sliver of savings we have left over? And quite frankly, the savings rate in America, I believe, is actually negative 2%. So I'm being generous when I say like a 3% savings.
Wow.
So,
and so what was number two? Number one was reduce your cost of borrowing, and number two was?
Make all your payments as tax efficient as possible.
As tax efficient as possible.
Wow. I'll give you a really good example of how to make your payments as tax efficient as possible. So say, for example, at the end of the year, you have $5,000 to go and invest into some sort of IRA, registered investment, or something like that. Or you can get yourself a home-based business like Amway or Melaleuc or Monavi or any of those millions and avons of multi-level marketing companies out there. If you went and picked up a home-based business where you were going to buy goods already from that business, whether it's groceries or clothes or health products, whatever it is, as long as you are operating it as a home-based business where you're just spending like an hour a week doing it, all your expenses are tax-deductible against your current income that you're making from a regular job. So if you were paying $5,000 in taxes, you may end up paying $3,000 in taxes. You've just guaranteed yourself a rate of return because you made all your payments as tax-efficient as possible. Does that make sense?
Yes, because wouldn't that be sort of like having your regular job and also having like a second job on a Schedule C?
Yeah. So basically what you're doing is, yeah, exactly. Now, mind you, I have to, you know, put a disclaimer here. I'm not American. So although I've seen a lot of American tax returns and things of that sort of nature, I just need to say that just for my own disclaimer. As long as if you have two jobs, one is a regular tax-paying job and the other one is a home-based business, and if your home-based business is unsuccessful, you get to write off all the expenses against your workable income. And that's essentially guaranteeing yourself a rate of return by reducing your taxes.
And sometimes
that's better than actually investing your money, is what I'm suggesting.
So if you had like a little bit business on the side, like you said, an Amway or a little import-export or even Avon, and you went to your regular job, because you can write off a lot in mileage and things like that, I would imagine. So
exactly. There are rules and regulations, and obviously talk to an accountant that knows what they're doing. Just don't take my word for it. Just make sure you talk to an accountant that's qualified, understands how this works, and off you go.
Wow. So there you have it, listeners, as far as making what you're paying on your taxes and the interest a little less. Now, how about investing? You talk about, putting a small payment. Well, I guess you could put it into a small business, but guaranteed rates of returns besides your taxes and interest, I mean, you know, by not paying as many out.
You talk about self. Are we talking about self financing here, or are we talking about paying off our homes?
Well, we can talk about either one.
Well, you know what? I figured since we're part of the Trent family, why don't we start off with paying off your home in half the time or less? I bet a lot of people would be interested in knowing how to do this.
Okay.
So, this is what a lot of people do with their homes: is they look. First of all, let's make sure everyone understands what the term mortgage means. Mortgage is French for death contract. It basically means that you're going to be paying this for the rest of your life. That's why these mortgages are 25, 35, 40 years. And what happens is that when you are paying these mortgages, so say, for example, a home costs you $250,000. Over a course of 25 to 30 years, you're probably going to be paying twice that amount in the form of compounded interest, amortized interest. So by the time you're done in that process, you have spent double the amount of money paying off your home. And what happens is that the banks will come by and say, well, we can get you a lower interest rate. Or maybe you're going to go, well, maybe if you make double payments, you know, biweekly payments, I could pay the home off faster. Well, that may be true. You have to also remember the fact that you are still paying all the front-end loaded interest. So it's the volume of the interest that will kill you, not the rate. So in Europe and in Australia and in a few other areas, including now Canada and now the United States are starting to catch up on these things, but in Europe and Australia, they have what's called in-and-out mortgages, or they have what's called European lending mortgages. So what happens is that you convert your mortgage into a simple interest loan or a home equity line of credit, like a credit card, and you combine it with your checking account. So say, for example, you have a mortgage that is, let's just say that you have a house that's worth $500,000, you know, just to give a round number. And that mortgage, say the mortgage interest rate is 5%, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And say you work every single month and you get $5,000 and you put that into your checking account. How much interest do you get back for putting $5,000 into your checking account?
Barely anything.
Zero, right?
Zero, right, because you said we actually are minus on the return of our money, but zero, yeah, nothing. Years ago, it used to work.
You get like 0.1% to 1%, mm-hmm. and if you have a little bit more money, you get 0.25%. So what the Europeans have discovered, and they've been doing this for decades, if not centuries, and I don't know how long this has gone back. I know for Australia, it's been for decades. And what they did is they combined both of them into a simple interest loan. So instead of paying 5% on $500,000, you're paying 5% on $495,000. And that is essentially the same, when you combine them, it's essentially the same as actually making 5% on your checking account tax-free.
Wow, so
because you're reducing your cost of borrowing. You're reducing the amount of interest you're paying.
The amount of interest. We're going to have to take a break, but now, so would we be able to break that down in the difference in savings?
Sure.
Okay.
Yep.
We want to know that real quick before the break. We've got about 30 seconds.
We're coming right down on the break here, bottom of the hour. Leslie and Laureen, hey, I want to ask you guys before we do the break.
Okay.
Laureen, would you press the red button in the studio there? Takes us back to a certain year. That's our time machine there. That'll take us to the break, and I'll ask Leslie, since we were talking about music earlier, and you too, Laureen, if you can identify the name of this guy singing here, it'll signify one thing, just how old you really are.
Okay.
You can mend a broken heart, I know
you
that.
You got it. Very good. And the name of the singer, he passed away last week. He was the second lead singer of the Temptations.
As I walk this land.
Wow.
Jimmy Ruffin.
Is this 19...
Laureen, I think you just dated yourself.
Yeah,
is this 1962,
yeah.
Wayne? Okay,
63.
We are... 63.
Yep.
Friends, November 22nd, 1963, the death of our beloved John F. Kennedy, our president, was this past Saturday, and we are celebrating with not only music on money, but music from 1963 and in a memorial for our John F. Kennedy, president, one of my most favorite.
Mine too. We'll be right back with Leslie Michael and Laureen Trent with more talk about money coming up next on WMEL. The weather forecast for Brevard County, high of 86, and low tonight 64, and clear skies all around the Space Coast, and that's why we live here.
Always moving and going.
AM 1300 WMEL.
Tom Costello in Washington. Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel is stepping down. President Obama confirmed Hagel's departure in a statement from the White House. He spoke of the politics in Washington.
Sometimes this town is so politicized. To have a friend who was willing to accompany a nominee from another party because he understood that whoever ended up being president, what was most important was that we were unified.
Hagel has resigned under pressure amid criticism of the president's national security team on a host of global issues. Hagel says there have been major reforms made by the Pentagon.
Reforms that will prepare this institution for the challenges facing us in decades to come.
The president says Hagel has been instrumental in putting together the U.S.-led coalition that is fighting ISIS. He's agreed to remain on the job until a successor is confirmed. This is NBC News Radio.
Hi, welcome to Healthburg Diamonds.
Hi there. We'd like to look at engagement rings. Wait, is that the guy Kogieko?
Oh, hello. I'm just admiring this lovely diamond solitaire ring.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, it is.
Well, that was easy. Now, who thinks it's a good idea to save money on their car insurance?
I do.
Wow. I think we just had the wedding rehearsal.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Your Ford dealer uses only Motorcraft parts, so you can be confident your Ford is properly serviced. Confident enough to write your own fortune cookies.
You are smart, good-looking, and eternally humble.
Now get up to $50 in mail-in rebates on any Motorcraft brake service when you use the Ford Service credit card.
Ford Service. Go with confidence.
Subject to credit approval, taxes extra, rebates by prepaid debit card, pants or shoes on most vehicles, one axle, exclusions apply. See your participating Ford dealer for rebate details through 12/31/14.
Hi, welcome to Healthburg Diamonds.
Hi there. We'd like to look at engagement rings. Wait, is that the guy Kogieko?
Oh, hello. I'm just admiring this lovely diamond solitaire ring.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, it is.
Well, that was easy. Now, who thinks it's a good idea to save money on their car insurance?
I do.
Wow. I think we just had the wedding rehearsal.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Honey, I had a premonition about Black Friday.
Let me guess, long lines and tons of people.
Nope, I saw great deals at Staples.
Were you on Staples.com when you had this vision?
I don't recall, but it was clear as day.
Uh-huh.
Blowout prices on laptops and headphones. You got me a tablet.
Did I?
Yeah, we were in, out, and home in time to have breakfast in bed.
You saw all that.
You made omelets.
Omelets.
Have a stress-free Black Friday at Staples. Go to Staples.com for deals and coupons good on the hottest tech gifts all week long. Less stress, more savings. Staples.
And a 20% chance of rain. Tonight has a 20% chance of rain as well, 68 for the low. Tuesday will have an 80% chance of rain throughout and a high of 77. Cooler on Wednesday with a high of 66 and a 60% chance of rain. Sunny skies for Thanksgiving with a high of 65 and a low of 50. It's Ed Dean, 5 to 7 p.m. weeknights on AM 1300 WMEL and worldwide at 1300WMEL.com.
Hi, Jim Bohannon here. Please join me for the next Bohannon Show. We'll be talking with Joe Hicks of Project 21 on whatever that grand jury does in Ferguson, Missouri. In addition, Patrick O'Donnell, the author of First Seals, the untold story of the forging of America's most elite unit. See you here.
It's Jim Bohannon, weeknights, 10 p.m. to 1 a.m. on AM 1300 WMEL and worldwide at 1300WMEL.com.
My family is always on the go. Between jobs, school, and activities for three kids, I schedule everything. But what I didn't schedule was time to sprain my ankle, tripping over my son's skateboard. Who has time to wait in an emergency room or urgent care clinic? Thanks to Health First, I didn't have to wait. I scheduled my care online at hfnow.org.
hfnow.org, powered by InQuicker, is the free online waiting service from Health First. It lets individuals with non-life-threatening medical conditions check in from their computer or mobile device for an estimated treatment time at the Health First emergency room or urgent care center nearest you.
So instead of sitting in a waiting room, I sat in my living room.